Our immune or defense system is much stronger than what we give it credit for, but you must give it the right conditions. And today I'm going to show you how.
Please follow us on Instagram at High Carb Health, and don't forget to click on that green H so you follow our stories and get to see everything that we eat and do throughout the day. If you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel, click on that subscribe button and the bell notification icon so you are notified of all future videos.
Hey guys, today I'm going to give you our best tips for improving your immune or defense system functionality. Now, in today's environment, the way our population is, closely packed in large cities, very dense populations, it's very, very difficult to avoid or completely eliminate contact from viruses or bacteria that are in our environment. So, you know, as much as we want to practice good hygiene and we want to make sure we're washing our hands and doing all of those good things, inevitably we're going to come across some form of virus or bacteria that could cause us harm if our body isn't able to defend itself. Now, today what I want to do is talk to you about how we can go about making sure that we give our defense or immune system the best possible chance for being able to deal with any kind of foreign invader that comes into our bodies. Now, as far as I'm concerned, the number one thing we can do to improve our immunity is to look at our diet. And we want to look at the ways or the types of diets that are proven to enhance our body's immune or defense functionality. So, in terms of the scientific research, what type of diet does this? It's a low-fat, plant-based diet. This is because there is some evidence that a high-fat diet can lead to a decrease in immune function. Whereas, according to this study, low-fat, high-carbohydrate diets are seen to increase the immune response in the body. So, eating a plant-based diet may give the immune system a boost. Why would this be? Well, the immune system relies on white blood cells that produce antibodies to combat bacteria, viruses, and other invaders. According to this study, vegetarians have been shown to have more effective white blood cells when compared to non-vegetarians, and this is because of a high intake of vitamins and a low intake of fat. So we know that a low-fat diet is protective, but what about respiratory tract infections? Because this is what COVID-19 seems to be affecting most people with, is the lungs and the respiratory tract. Now, there's limited evidence around the benefits of diet when it comes to RTIs or respiratory tract infections, but some of the available evidence is very interesting. Now, this study from the 1980s showed that there was no difference in the white blood cell count between meat eaters and people who follow a plant-based diet. Awesome, so it doesn't really matter what diet we follow, right? Wrong. There was one major difference. One very important type of immune cell called a natural killer cell was much more active in the plant-based group than the meat eater group. And what do natural killer cells do? Well, as you can see in this video, they are responsible for killing cells that are infected with viruses. So we want these type of cells to be more active and vigorous in their efforts to protect us, especially in times of pandemic type situations, because we want to make sure that our body is going to have the best possible opportunity to fight off any kind of invader. Now, this study suggested that there was increased protection not only for respiratory tract infections, but also for cancer. And there was also this study from Australia which showed that respiratory tract infections were lower in people who ate plant-based diets in every age group. And even more interestingly, RTA rates in vegetarians were higher than those who ate a high fruit and vegetable intake in their diet. So why do you think we recommend eating so much fruit and vegetable? Why do you think our diet is so full of fruits? Because these are the most protective foods for the body's immune or defense system. So while that study concluded that a plant-based diet may be beneficial, what it said was that people who are eating a high fruit and vegetable intake may have the optimal diet when it comes to RTIs and fighting off infections. So therefore, a low-fat, plant-based diet, high in the consumption of fruits and vegetables, may be the optimal way of eating to protect yourself or to increase or boost your immune or defense system. And therefore, eating foods that are high in fat are going to provide us with compromises in our immunity. The other thing about high-fat diets is that they alter the gut microbiome in a way that we don't want. In fact, they alter it to the point where we get the wrong type of bacteria in our gut. And because our gut is such a huge part of our immunodefense system, having a compromised gut microbiome can affect our body's immunity or the ability for our body to fight off infections. Now, according to this study, what we can see is that when people follow a high-fat diet, you can just see the differences in the type of bacteria that's in their bowels. So a high-meat diet and you get the wrong type of bacteria, a low-fat, high-fiber diet or plant-based diet, you get the right type of symbiotic bacteria in your bowel. So just ask yourself, what type of immune function do you want? High-fat diet, which is going to compromise your immune system, or a low-fat, plant-based diet, which is going to give your body the best ability to work as well as it needs to. And this is what I was saying when I talked about you want to give your body the right conditions to deal with any type of scenario that comes up. And when you've got this kind of issue going on in the world, make sure that you are doing the best thing that you can for your immune or defense function, which is to follow a low-fat, plant-based diet and make sure you're eating lots of fruits and vegetables. Now, while we're talking about fruits and vegetables, there was this really interesting study in the British Journal of Nutrition in 1999. The researchers recruited non-smoking adult men and asked them to not eat many fruits and vegetables for 2 weeks. Following those 2 weeks of not eating a large quantity of fruits and vegetables, these men were asked to drink tomato juice for 2 weeks, then carrot juice for 2 weeks, and then dried spinach for 2 weeks. And what they found was when they were not eating many fruits and vegetables, their immune system was compromised, meaning they had decreased immune function compared to when they started to increase the amount of fruit and vegetables. So it just backs up more about what we've been talking about. Interestingly, the tomato juice was able to increase the immune function significantly. So, you know, maybe if you want to have some tomato juice every now and then, it's going to do you good. But what about people who are at a higher risk of respiratory tract infections? And I know there's a large group of people that follow us with ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease that are on immunosuppressive medication that are obviously at a higher risk of getting these kind of respiratory tract infections or being affected by viral or bacterial complications. Other groups that are at high risk are infants as well as older adults. So we saw this study here that looked at a group of adults aged 65 years and older who had a low intake of fruit and vegetables. So these people were eating less than 2 servings of fruits and vegetables per day. So this group of people was randomized to continue their normal diet or increase their fruit and vegetable intake to 5 servings a day. Now, what they found was that the antibody response in the group of people eating 5 servings of fruits and vegetables a day was much higher than the group of people that were eating 2 servings of fruits and vegetables a day. Now, what this means is that there was a greater immune response in the group of people that was eating more fruits and vegetables. Now, fruits and vegetables are also shown to reduce infection risk in pregnant women. This study in 2010 covered 1,000 pregnant women in Boston and reported those eating the most fruits and vegetables had a 39% reduced risk of respiratory tract infections. So you know how the saying goes, an apple a day keeps the doctor away. Well, they actually tested this out when it comes to respiratory tract infections. And what do they find? Well, eating just one apple a day reduced your risk of getting a respiratory tract infection by 16%. So there we go. I think the science is very, very clear when it comes to nutrition and what you need to do to make sure that you make your immune system function the best that it can and you decrease your risk of getting infections, and especially the respiratory type infections that we see with COVID-19. A low-fat, plant-based diet, high carbohydrate, high fruit and vegetable content is the way to make sure that you give your immune system the best type of boost that you can. Now, apart from diet, what are some other things you can do to increase your immunity or your defense system functionality? Well, sleep. I cannot hark on this enough. Sleep is extremely important for overall health and well-being. And it's something that I talk to my clients about every single day. Make sure you get enough sleep. And when it comes to your immune system, what is the benefit of sleep? Well, in this study, they looked at over 22,000 Americans. A short sleep duration was associated with an increased respiratory tract infection risk of 82%. What they also found in this study was that those who sleep 7 or less hours every night are 200% more likely to develop a cold than people who sleep 8 hours or more every night. So therefore, sleep is extremely important to making sure that you maintain immune function, to make sure that you maintain a healthy lifestyle, to give your body the best conditions to make sure that your immune or defense system works in the best way that it can. Now, if you're having trouble falling asleep, a plant-based diet can be extremely helpful for this. For example, this study showed that diets rich in fiber and low in saturated fat can lead to deeper, more restorative sleep. So there you go, the plant-based diet is the best thing, not only for immune function, but also helps you fall asleep and keeps your sleep deeper, longer, to give you better rest. And therefore, your immune function will be enhanced as a result of this. In these studies here, we saw that excess alcohol consumption can lead to decreased immune function. Now, there's no surprise there. Alcohol is a class 1 carcinogen. We know that it is toxic on a cellular level. There's nothing really beneficial about it. And what surprised me a lot when this announcement of COVID-19 and the lockdown was established was that the alcohol shelves are also being emptied. I mean, come on, guys, we need to make sure that we stay away from this poisonous substance to make sure that our immune system can function exactly the way it's designed to. And the final thing I want to talk to you about today is stress. Now, we see this a lot in our work. When you're stressed, your immune function is compromised. It's not going to work the way you want it to work. It's just going to be depressed and suppressed. So what we want to be doing is things that are going to improve our ability to stay calm under duress. And if we can do these things, you're going to have a benefit. Now, what did we see for the immune response when it came to stress? Well, this study showed that physiological stress has been shown to weaken the immune system. And this study showed that increased stress increases your risk of respiratory tract infections. On the other hand, there is some evidence that stress management is associated with an increase in the functionality of the immune system. Okay, guys, well, there's a lot of information to go through, but I think really important that you are aware of some of the science around how a plant-based diet can actually improve our body's immune or defense system so that we can better cope with dealing with these type of viruses and bacteria. Now, as I said at the start, we can't always make sure that we're going to be isolated from these viruses at all times. Even once we get back into the daily life, we're going to have to deal with some of these things. We might get exposed to certain viruses, and there's like 200 different viruses around in the world today anyway, or more. So what we need to do is make sure that our body is given the right conditions so that our immune system or our defense system can function at its peak. And the best way to do that is to eat a low-fat diet, high in fruits and vegetables, which is the optimal way to do this. So a plant-based diet, high in carbohydrates, high in fruits and vegetables is what you need to be looking to do. Other things we can do is make sure that we're sleeping well, make sure that we're well hydrated, make sure that we exercise moderately, and that we make sure we manage our stress levels too. Okay? If we do all these things, we're going to make sure that we give our body the best possible ability to fight off any kind of infection that we may come across. Well, I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this, subscribe to our channel and click on that little bell notification so that you're notified of all our future videos. I'd like to thank you so much for watching, guys, and until next time, eat plants and lots of them.
Give this video a thumbs up if you know what it's like to live with IBD, and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. This channel is designed to help people recover from colitis, Crohn's, and any other form of IBD. You can always head to our website, highcarbhealth.com, for a free 30-minute consultation from anywhere in the world. And remember, there is a life after colitis.